125. Go up there at 125, tell her we're here. Access, or is there a back one?
She's giving the dogs though.
Okay.
Sorry.
All
right. So.
Is there a back access?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Understood.
Yeah, make sure that
this one?
Yeah, would you?
Inside door,
to make sure. Yeah. No, they're both. As long as they're both closed, I'm good, because I have two goldens in there. He'll love on you all day.
The street.
Yeah, they're coming back tomorrow, and they said if you can get this, our end of the line came, we're gonna come back with camera and run it all the way to the street.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I remember right, this is our main line going up.
Okay, we got a 2-inch line. Running down past the washers to the left. And what side of the building? This is left side facing. So
yeah.
Facing the street, we'll be heading out left side towards the main.
I mean, I can take you over to mine. That's not a problem. You can look at both.
What, you have access over there?
Yep. Mine's on the other side. This is the other guy's house. He gives me access anytime if he works overnight.
Your pipes come over to this one, though?
I do believe so.
Oh, okay.
My husband isn't here right at the moment, but I can ask him real quick.
Okay. What do we have for... that window's open, right, bud? I see crack. Okay. I see crack in the ground.
Yeah, you gotta turn the... There's nails holding it.
Okay.
Looks like yep, hinges
one
up.
Nail here.
Hinges up.
Okay, so we'll probably run the hose in through here.
So the main drain is on here, right?
Okay. There, I put it back down so we can... The hose will pop through there.
So we don't have hose
there? Right.
Yet.
Yes, my husband said everything drains into this side.
Okay.
And I believe this is our sink. And dishwasher coming over from the other side that feeds into this.
And which one, which fixture were you having trouble with? Your sinks?
Both kitchen sinks are backing up. See, this is off. This is our kitchen sink and dishwasher teeing into this.
I mean, that's a pretty long lateral to assume that the pipe isn't working outside. So once I open this pipe... Once I open this one up, I'll be able to tell what's going on. But is this actually water weeping out? Oh yeah, that's water weeping out. So yeah, so actually this might actually be full. Yeah, you're right. I mean, especially if Greg said that it was plugged out that way last time and all this water.
Yeah, last time they came from here and went with a snake all the way in.
And they had to go outside with a tool. Okay, understood. Thank you. I'll make sure that you run some water from your sink and that it's going there when I'm done.
Yeah.
Yep.
Love on you all day, but...
All right, we'll knock. We'll make sure we knock at things. Very good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Not a problem.
So we're exiting around here. Yep, she's going below. You want me a relief brake? Jesus. Think it's gonna snap in half?
I think so.
Oh, damn it.
Yeah, I guess I'll probably have to drill that out, dude.
I found it on it, but we're just gonna. There's gonna be stuff that's gonna fall right down that. It's just gonna keep cracking and. No point fucking with it now. Might as well just get them open. A little restricted right here for sure. Having the sewer drop into that, but it's actually behind that, isn't it? It's behind that. Is that the fucking cast? Just goes all the way down through that? Or that blockage? Oh well, we'll slip the camera by that and get it to the exterior. Exterior. Look, I'm gonna, probably gonna need to open this up right here. Get a 5/16 driver or your scissors. Okay, will you have her, just yell up to her? Oh yeah, she's not in that apartment. It ain't plugged. That pile of rust. Well, we gotta have a runner sink and make sure that this 2-inch line is open. Wait, what the hell is that? We'll throw the camera in there and turn it out. Little pile of schmutz. It's at the ABS going into the cast, so we gotta make sure we're getting flow this way first. Alright, give her a call with the phone charger on the water. Look. Alright, so we'll run the little sewer generator up that, bud. Drag it out on the floor. She said she was still backed up. Oh, there's a clean out right here. And then there's some fittings right here. I guess we might as well take this off and see if we got water here or not. Oh yeah, it's heavy.
It's heavy over there.
Then that's where the blockage probably is. I'm gonna take that off with the, I'm gonna pull that clean out, see if it's leaking at all. Oh, is it because it like goes up or something? No?
I don't know, it's just really heavy there.
Alright. We'll take that off. We'll cut that from the roof too.
Sorry.
Okay, so this pipe here, this interior 2-inch lateral is plugged. See how it's dripping here? See how it's dripping there?
Yeah.
Okay, understood. And then see how we have it taken apart here?
Yeah.
No water's coming out?
Well, it's starting to drip now.
That's because we messed with it. You see how it's really light right here?
Yep. The other end's heavy.
And I would say that right here it's really heavy.
Yep.
So right here is where your blockage location is. And, like probably just right residual grease and soap and food particles from regular dishes and things. and I'll just run my hose up through there and drag everything out right here. And I did open this up just so that I could make sure that we have some flow. I just opened the plug. I just opened the cap, excuse me.
Yeah, no, I get it.
I didn't do anything from here out, but
that's what my husband was worried about, was this line and not there.
It is this line and not there. Yeah. So they can still come back in camera, but
yeah.
You know.
They're going to.
machine off.
Yep. Back up and verify we got all the meat out of there. 125 Haley Street, end service. And you can see we got a temporary plug in this. Ain't going nowhere. Nothing, no air is gonna come out of it. So we're gonna leave that in there until they decide what to do. We can always drop by and put a 2-inch plug in it. Probably be the best bet. Today we cleaned out this interior 2-inch, stripped it about 98% of grease and soap buildup. You can see it starts down here at this elevation, and then it rises over here to much higher, about 2 inches higher, and then it starts to drop back over to the cast iron. That's why it was full, about 10, 12 feet of solid grease and soap buildup. It's just residual from normal dish use and normal cleaning and normal showering. It's probably just 2 kitchen lines. Either way, that's why it's backing up. For today's issue, was the interior. We also ran to make sure, we ran the camera down through the interior clean out to the exterior main, through the exterior lateral. The exterior lateral is complete crap. Heavy scale buildup, cast iron, a few sags. Yeah, you're good to button her up, bud. Button her up. How's the top of that wash machine?
Does it look all right? Here's all right. I'm cleaned up. Cool, man. Just a little dirt from the. Let's get this corner out there. Sweet. All right, thanks, man. I'm gonna take a video of the front yard real quick.
Long sag here where the lateral is past the curb, goes into the main cast iron. Long sag there. Heavy scale buildup. Some sagging crossing the yard. Tech recommends installing clean out bi-directional, so you can go approximately 18 feet up to the clean out on the interior. It's cast iron still, heavy scale buildup. And then you can go out to the main if you use a bi-directional clean out. So I wrote install clean out byway 6'5" deep. And you're gonna wanna do that right there, somewhere in this location. As long as dependent on the gas and everything else, water and gas that's coming in. Have all that marked by UFPO and then make your decision on whether you want to clean out here bi-directional or clean out here bi-directional. So that'll save somebody from having to drag their tools through the basement and get into that interior clean out. You can do everything from the exterior, save time and money. It's a lot of infrastructure if you want it replaced from here back up 18 feet into the building to replace all the cast iron. So, I mean, there's a couple different ways of doing this. Probably the cheapest would be just patching a bi-directional clean out. Make sure you coat the fittings good so that you don't end up with root infiltration in the clean out.